Hello, everybody. Is there anybody who has seen my talk on Monday about blends or so? Because some people. So I will repeat something, only a few things, because I think it became important even more than after I heard the other talk. I'm a little bit astonished because this is kind of a side byproduct of my main topic, and this ended up in the main talk room and the whatever. Okay, what about MOM? MOM is called Mentoring of the Month, and Mentoring of the Month was one of my ideas which came exactly at the same time. You see, it's January last year. My own mail was sent one day later, but was just prepared. We had one post on our mailing list who wrote, "Dear Debian packagers, we are looking for one of you to help us change the history of healthcare," and blah, blah, blah. It was, well, actually, he was quite engaged and wanted to have a really large, heavy hospital management system packaged. And we had it on our to-do list, but it was so hard that we wouldn't not be able to do it without any help from upstream, because it's quite complex. And well, I'm personally a physicist, have no idea about all this stuff, so I can have the knowledge about packaging, and upstream has the knowledge about the upstream program. So in my opinion, this is quite a good fit. And basically at the same time, I have written the announcement of the Mentoring of the Month. It is, well, it was by chance connected to the 10th birthday of Debian Med, but I learned in these 10 years of Debian Med that there are people showing up and say, "Hey, I want to support you a little bit, and I would like to do something," and then you hear never again something from this person. Anybody had the same experience? So, whatever. So, in the non-free world, there is a boss, and he gives money to somebody, and if this somebody doesn't doing what he is supposed to do, he will be fired. That's easy. In the free software world, it's not that easy. So what to do to get at least some slight handle on this person? And so I came up with the idea to say, well, I will spend my time to teach you, and you are supposed to do some work and do some reports and so on and so on. I will tell you how it works in detail, but first I want to show you another interesting thing. In the Debian Med team, we have about 23 Debian developers and maintainers who are not all very active, but because we are doing some mentoring, because we're doing advertising of the project, we have 10 Debian developers who confirmed that they are only in Debian because the Debian Med project exists. So Debian Med is a leaf project. Nobody really cares much about it in the main Debian universe. It's not important for several reasons. But even if this small, unimportant project can gather 10 developers who otherwise would not be in Debian, we could do a lot of stuff more. And one point of this is because we really care for our newcomers. 7 of these people even dived in other fields inside Debian, so do not even necessarily be active in Debian Med anymore, and 8 of them are working active in Debian Med. Okay, what is Mentoring of the Month? The mentor, currently only me, but that's is not necessarily the case, just dedicates this part as of his spare time. Well, it's anyway my spare time, what I'm doing for Debian, and so I cut a little bit from packaging myself and spend the time for the student. He should try to guide the student kindly into all secrets of Debian packaging, and I think learning by example is the best way you can do something. So it does not really help to reproduce a hello package, which is fine, but it's not full of pitfalls. And usual real life examples have a lot of pitfalls you need to work around. And we, in this process, I also faced something which made some trouble for me, and it's even more trouble for the newcomer. So if the newcomer has a package he's interested in, and basically we had a lot of these students, they are upstream developers, so have a real interest to get it packaged. They learn it on their real example. And it's not necessarily upstream developers, so the student is free to pick the package, and I as a mentor reserve some vetoing rights, just because I have sometimes experience that it's too hard to do this in 1 month. It's just some to say, well, it's nice if you want to package this, but this doesn't work. For instance, we have in DBMed, we have some kind of to-do list. Well, we have these task pages, and we have here some packages where is some work done in SVN or Git, and you can just continue something what is started, or we have some other thing which are not really started with. So we have some obviously long to-do list where students could pick from or could do something else. So, the goals of mentoring of the month. Well, the package in question is finished and uploaded after 1 month, and the student is able to do advanced packaging tasks and is also introduced into the communication channels of DebianMed. I always want to make the student to communicate via my mailing list. I personally don't like mails popping up in my private mailbox. There should be always some public record which you can seek for, and so the communication and the package. The communication, as I said, on mailing lists. I don't know why, but this, I always face people who are too shy to post a mailing list or whatever, but this is something I really want the students to do. And well, other readers might be bothered a little bit by this education, and so it should be just tagged by the MOM tag, so people could filter it, or perhaps even people are only interested in this mentoring, and then they could read it as well. I have set 5 rules. One of these is the responsiveness. So if the mentor is posting something in the mailing list with the MOM subject, the student should really try hard to comment on this. So, I have no idea what you mean, can you help me, or explain better, or just, the student should just respond with something. It's quite frequent that you post something and you think the message is received, but it is not really. So this is this handshake principle you know from electronics. Sender, the receiver said, yes, I've got it. The student should also confirm understanding. He should say, well, this is okay, or what does it mean? Please explain. Or he can also say, I would prefer this or that over mine, because I'm not that strict on my opinion, because newcomers maybe have more ideas about the upstream program than me, so they are way more right than I. Or maybe there's an alternative, and I do not want to put my strong opinion onto the student. The student should also follow changes. He should subscribe to the commit lists, and or alternatively should pull from the repository and read the log files. And the student should also try to find a useful comment to confirm that he understand what was committed, because sometimes I can explain to the student, please do this or that change. But sometimes it's way longer to explain what to do, and I just commit a small change, put a comment on it, and then the student get also the message, and it's more straightforward. So it's not that I want to do all the coding to put on the student. If there's something available in the repository, the student should confirm that he was able to build the package, right? you cannot always be sure that student just checks out everything and knows the process of building. So I want him to say, well, I was able to build and is everything fine. I continue working with this. Well, it's in case of problems, the student should ask on the DebianMate mailing list, also with mom subject, and he should show to others we are working on a problem, so others might join or not. Things should be sorted out via open discussion, and there are possibly, most possibly, a lot of silent lurkers on our mailing list. We do not even know who is subscribed and who's reading it, and perhaps other people could learn it. Alternatively, you could do the MOM with IRC channel. I admit I'm not so frequently on IRC, basically only on DebConf, but if the student prefers this, we could do some meetings also to get some faster communication. And the student should post reports. What he has done, what's he doing every day, so how is the progress working? And I think these reports are the way to prove that he is really working on what we agreed upon, because I agreed upon teaching the students and the students just reports back and shows that he did understand something. In summary, I can say mentoring of the month is work for both, but I really think if you work on it, it also shows that it's fun to work, because both people can learn something. The mentor trades his spare time for the work of the student, and he also trains silent observers. And the focus is not only on the technical details, but also on learning to know relevant communication channels. This is also quite an interesting thing, because we have a lot of people working silently on their own and do not really know how to find friends. After hearing the talk this morning about the woman in Debian, and I've seen that Paultec has some statistics that in Google Summer of Code, 0% women applicants out of 181, but in Google Outreach Program for Women, they had 100 applicants. I'm wondering, should I explicitly dedicate every second month for women only or so? I don't know, but I don't know if it helps, because we are quite niche projects, if there are really so much many women, but I could consider this or try this. If other projects might adopt this idea of MOM, it could be some way to help also here. As a result, we had in the first year four MOM periods, and in this year one. I have not a student every month, so well. And the most interesting thing is actually the first one. It's not yet uploaded, but in this MOM work, Upstream learned that they need to change their build system and changed a lot, and so we need to wait for the next Upstream, which is supposed to be happen soon. And finally, we got something into Debian, or we will get something really soon, which we never managed over all the 10 years of DebianMate existence. So this is a really valuable thing to train people, because otherwise we wouldn't manage it. So finally, I think this is kind of good result. It also happened that people put their name on the queue. We are using a wiki page. I will show you the link in the end. And there's a table, and you put your name in the table, and everything is quite informal. And so, and some people consider doing it and then manage. So what can I do? As I said, I cannot fire anybody. As a conclusion, I think the time I spent into mentoring is really worth the effort. Because you have not student for every month, the workload is bearable somehow. So I think It's not way much more than I'm doing anyway, because I do not restrict my teaching work on the mailing list to this project. I'm teaching on the mailing list anyway, and so it's a little bit more formalized and a bit more strict, and hopefully inviting. And actually, I'm also learning myself, because I'm a Debian developer for 15 years. I'm not really sure if I have read every document which should be read, and specifically, I have not read them the last 10 years. So the student is new and reads the documents, and I'm learning. I'm really learning. I learn features I would never have learned if I wouldn't have done this teaching. The major advantage for me is that by the training, we could pull up the knowledge of upstream and our packaging stuff, and this is a very efficient way to get packages which are really hard for us to do. So, sponsoring of blends, what does it mean? Well, I learned that the blends concept is widely unknown amongst newcomers and also amongst Debian developers. I'm talking about blends since 2003, DebConf 3, and with different names, but people are widely ignoring this topic or thinking, well, it's a cool idea, but we have no time to do it. And well, this is fine. Everybody can spend his time as he wants. But the thing is that newcomers might desperately seek for a sponsor and simply don't know how to find one, right? But in principle, every blend should have a team around and should be really, really involved in sponsoring the packages. But some blends doesn't fly in the sense that there is some maintainer having a package and asking for sponsoring and Debian mentors list. So, what can you do? I think we could kill two birds with one stone. We can get the package sponsored after proving that you understood the blends techniques. How do I think about this? Well, I personally want to make the blends concept way more popular than it currently is. And the maintainer of a package which could be in a blend is seeking a sponsor, so we can find a common solution. Also here, there are some rules. Sponsoring of blends means the first rule is the maintainer should confirm that he has understands the blends principle. That means have read the blends documentation, is a member of some team on Elliott, on reading the relevant mailing list. I frequently observe that there are ITPs, I'm always reading the ITP list, which are relevant for, say, geographic information systems, multimedia, games. And these people are single maintainers, not really connected to a team. And I always say, well, would you consider maintaining this in this team or in the Debian science team or so, to get some connection to people? So I really, really hope that if this seek for a sponsor is makes obvious that this person has no contact, I try to get this contact via the blends. So the second rule is your package is maintained in a VCS used by the blends team. The technical background behind is we are checking the VCS here in our blends tools, and it shows up here. So if a package is in SVN, all the information is obtained from SVN. So if you really put your packaging there, you have to do nearly nothing to show up on the web page. So this is so one thing. It is to make the sponsee aware of this, and the other thing is that we get the information straight. Your package is listed on the blends task pages, which I've shown you, which is really, really easy. You just put an additional line in a control file, like file. It's very easy, and then after one day of once the contrib was running, it is there. So the world knows about your package, and you get some extra chance that somebody might pick it and sponsor it. And the fourth rule is, if you are unable to find a sponsor on the specific blends list, even after posting there at least twice, I will sponsor it for you. So you should seek in your own team, and if the team doesn't cope with it, I will do it. So these are the rules. This concept is quite new, and we have only two cases for the moment. One was sponsored, and this was fine, and the other one, I sent some change requests, please change this and that, and got no response. I think 2 or 3 months. Yeah. The question was how new is new. So I do not really remember when I announced this, but 2 or 3 months. And I'm also lurking on relevant mailing lists, and I'm reading Debian mentors, and I try to catch maintainers in need of a sponsor. I'm also lurking, for instance, on the list of derivatives. There is OS Geo distribution, which is finally an Ubuntu derivative, who is in principle competing with the Debian GIS team. They don't know each other. They also want to make a GIS distribution of free software. They don't know from each other, but should. They do also not know that there is a Debian Java team, but there would be some need. They are asking question, how can I package Java applications? And I write to the mailing list, well, there is a Debian Java list, and then nothing happens. So I also, if I see there is some package near to be ready, I post to them. You could get it into Debian Stride if you follow these 4 rules. Not yet. So I think the thing is new. I'm always sending the link to the wiki page and hope that something will happen. If you might notice that there is some candidate for this sponsoring of Blends rules, please redirect them to me. I hope I can bear the rush you put on me now. So, and what I just put on the slides when I was sitting in your talk is the third thing. So, mentoring of the month, sponsoring of Blends, and there is also face-to-face meeting. And yet, now I'm coming to the repetition of what I said on Monday. I want to have you a very quick look what happened since 2011 when we started doing yearly sprints in our team. And in the sprints, we not only were Debian developers, we were upstream developers and users. About 20, 25 people sitting together. We had in 2011 in January, last year in February, and this also in February. And the effect is really amazing. And by the way, thanks to Debian for sponsoring the sprints. You see here the usual statistics. You might ignore that I'm always this large red line. But what you see here, 2011, you have a solid base compared to this one. These are newcomers. And these newcomers are constant. And actually, these people who are longstanding, these are longstanding ones, might drop their activity. So 2011, you have some obvious increase in the uploads of Debian Mate packages. Next metric is the discussion on the Debian Mate user mailing list. You see quite the same effect, right? You have another thing, Debian developer mailing list, also 2011. It is an increase, a measurable increase. Who is fixing bugs in the Debian Mate team? You see, since 2011, a lot more people fixing bugs, right? And commits to the Debian Mate VCS, same effect. So it's quite consistent. And finally, in the packages we have in Debian Mate, we have a lot of biology packages, and this sprint were actually biology developers. So the increase is in this biology section you see here. The other are quite constant, increasing, but you don't see this increase. So if you meet face-to-face with interested people, you get some drastic effort for your project, even if it's such a side project, leaf project like Debian Mate. I can't stop saying this. If we would do all this stuff in multimedia, GIS, games or so, we could have a lot of more people. So we always had the discussion here. I have in two talks or three talks here heard that people have trouble finding friends in Debian. I've read on the mailing list. Well, it is not that hard. The answer is create inviting teams around certain topics. That if somebody comes to Debian with a certain interest, and everybody has some interest to install Debian, why shouldn't he otherwise? So if it should be natural, so for me it's, if I'm a biologist, I'm looking around what distribution has the most biological packages, that's Debian, let's try it. And then it comes and sees, there's a team behind it. And then you will contact the team. This is quite a natural thing since 2011 or so. Formerly there was not so much. So create strong teams and you will make it very easy for others to find new members for your team. By the way, this is my definition for a team. Waking up in the morning and realizing that somebody else has solved your problem from yesterday. And I really have realized this. We have some Debian developer in the team who just joined the Debian team because it's fun in this team. It's Thorsten Alterholz. He's not connected to biology, medicine anyway, but he said, that's fun, let's join this. And he's doing QA work, it's nice. And he made some, in December, some advent calendar to push people to fix a bug every day, to close the window or whatever. So this is really fun and it works because we try to invite people. So these are some links. Our policy document, which is also helpful for newcomers. Maybe this is even a fourth point here, that newcomers can read the main points, how to behave inside the team. Mentoring of the month, sponsoring of blends, and that's basically all. I will upload this PDF document and you can click on the links. And now, I talked two-thirds of this BOF. I just want to hear new ideas, new whatever, any comments. Raise your hands, please. Yes, some question.
Tell us more about organizing a sprint.
Yes. There is a mailing list, Debian Sprints, at list.debian.org. Yeah, you will. Should I go? We can check out. There is a mailing list, okay. Debian Sprints, and there you can announce that you want to do a sprint. And then you should create a wiki page with some information given, and you fill in location and so. There is a template you just fill in. Luca?
Yes, about sprints. Please organize sprints. I mean, we have clearly have the budget for that. If you think it's useful for your team, just contact me or the Debian Sprint mailing list. And it's really easy to organize as well.
If I understood the question correctly, it was kind of about what are the steps required to organize a sprint. Can you explain the steps? You began to talk about there's this wiki page, but then what do you need to know? What planning do you need to do? How do you invite people? These sorts of things, I think.
Yes, okay. I'm very happy that somebody in our team is doing all the work for this, and I just have to come to the sprint. That's nice. He is caring for some hotel. We have the rule to meet at some place at the beach. It was in Lübeck, it was in Southport in England, and it was close to Kiel, wherever. Find a small hotel, preferably with some better bandwidth than we have chosen, but and then try to find people. And this person in our team has a very good ability to attract people I would never think about. He is writing emails to people, hey, you have this package and you might be interested in this and that, and please come to our sprint. And he writes to 50 people and 20 or so will come. This is a good mix of Debian developers and other people, and this makes some point. There were even Ubuntu people on the sprint. There were even derivatives from Ubuntu, which is called BioLinux. And the effect of after our first sprint was that these BioLinux people are now using the same VCS as we. So we are working on the same code. And the package migrated via detour of Ubuntu to their distribution. And if they have changes, we incorporate it. And if we do changes, they have it as well. So this is quite efficient. So try to find friends for your project. And then put them in one place. And lock the doors. So services, pizza and cola or whatever.
How long have these do your sprints last, and how many have you run since 2011?
We have run three, one per year, and they run from Friday afternoon to Sunday evening, depending how much. So a little bit longer than a weekend. Any more questions? Can also keep on talking about this, the other mentoring stuff. We have 15 minutes left, barely. So if you have other ideas how we can get new developers, or we can create a friendly environment for men and women.
Do you think it would help if to have more blends for not so specific users, maybe. Let's put names. What about having a blend for SFC desktop or multimedia desktop or?
Yes, I think this is a good idea, and because you say not so specific. You need to decide how narrow you make the focus of your blend. For instance, in Debian you have a GIS team and an OpenStreetMap team, and both have common packages and both are separate. I don't think this is a good idea. You need to get some critical mass to put that there are perhaps 10 developers and not 3 there and 5 there. And then it could fly. For instance, if I started with medicine, nobody immediately connects biology with medicine, but in biology was a lot of stuff. It was there, we used it. And so this built some creative base, and then other things came around. So try to make it large enough to last some time, to get some critical mass. I think there's another question.
Well, I think the idea of blends here is really interesting. It sounds almost like they're just a collection of people who use Debian who care about some topic of packages.
Yes.
And the fact that there is a blend is almost separate from the fact that it's just people who are interested in that topic of packages. There's no reason you couldn't have like a Debian email sprint or something.
No. Well, you can do the sprints on any topic, yes.
And so I guess the thing that I'm trying to think through is that what you're talking about with blends just makes me think it's some notion of teams. And I guess I'm struggling to see the difference between blends and teams. And maybe we should try harder to make more topical collections of packages be in a team.
Well, the blend is actually a team working together on a certain user-oriented topic, right? It is user-oriented for certain works, for certain work fields, and you have some tasks in it. And my idea was just to attract people who are not necessarily geeks, but just want to do their normal work with Debian. And I assumed that we would have way more blends, but I pushed the principle on people. I wrote the stuff for the Debichem team, all the framework, I put it on the, and they said, well, that's nice. And they use it now. And there's also this Debian Science blend, which is actually we should have a Debian Mathematics, Debian Physics, Debian electronics or so, but there is nobody really engaged in, well, separating it out and making a real team around this topic. We would need such people who are doing this.
And I think, if I understand correctly, the core concept of a blend is that it's a variant of Debian that, when installed, contains all of those packages. Is that right?
Yes. A blend is completely integrated into Debian.
Right. But it's not just that it's integrated. It's that there's an installable, a sub-installable, well, Debian that provides that.
It's installable via meta packages. We would like to have something to say, well, create a DVD just with this blend. We have the idea. It was asked on Monday in IRC. You could put it on Task Cell that just select your blend. There is an open bug report, I think from 2003 or so, which won't fix.
I mean,
sounds, what should I say?
It sounds to be like, and I haven't thought this through very carefully, so it might just be crazy, that we should just rename blends to topics.
Yeah, the naming topic, you have not seen my talk, but the name of blends changed over the time. I can repeat this, we have time. It was first Debian internal projects, and we wanted to split from this technical project, the user-oriented. This was somehow logical. And then somebody suggested custom Debian distributions, which was a total failure, because if you hear this, you are smiling, you know. So, well, and I suggested Debian internal solutions or something like this, which sounded not that bad in my opinion, but once I did this, people raised their hand. I have never seen these people before. I have never written any code, seen any code from them. They are not posting on the mailing list, but once there was a name, they wanted their opinion on. They raised their hand and said, well, I have an opinion. We should not use this name. We should use something else. And then there was some voting, and now it's called blends. So I do not really want to go this street twice.
I see. I personally see quite some use for blends for having people being able to provide multiple variants of Debian for security, one for maybe live CD for security purposes, and some of them might be overlapping, but
There is also now overlap. We have overlap between DBSM and Debian Mid, so there is overlap.
And I think it's fine to have them overlapping. It's just also a way of having people not forking Debian just for a specific need. Yeah. It can help having those people work inside Debian and contribute inside Debian rather than forking and having their own. Yeah.
For me, it's a blending kind of making a Debian derivative the right way by staying inside Debian, and maybe you finally can do some nice background or what and release something as your product, but it's done inside Debian.
Yeah, and I think the key concept you have about keeping the work inside Debian is well taken. For me, I kind of didn't realize that blends, I thought that the point of blends was to create non-derivative derivatives. Mm-hmm. Like, an installable Debian med image or something. But it sounds like you don't even have an installable Debian med image, and why would you want one? Because you can app get install Debian med, or whatever the meta package is called. So it seems like we should try hard to run around to all of the users of Debian who have friends who are DDs and say, is there a topic of Debian you care about? Create a blend today.
This is what I'm doing since 2003.
Sorry,
we have now 10 years of doing...
I'm sorry that I'm so late to the party.
Yeah, well... This is actually my point. I was with this blends topic. I was degraded to the second talk room, and there were basically people, medicine also related, and other people think, well, this stuff that is not interesting for me. And now I'm here for getting a larger team, and people, I got more attention. Perhaps it was this way. On my next DebConf in my talk, the term blends will not happen. I will find a funny title and talk about it, and let's see. So, any other questions? We have 5 minutes left.
Is it easy to discover the meta packages that make up a blend at the moment, mechanically?
I hope so. It has a common prefix also.
Okay, well, in that case, Could we not have a submenu on the expert install or whatever?
We could have a lot of time, but the fact that that this task cell stuff was not accepted didn't.
Well, I'm not talking about task cell. I'm talking about at the initial install.
Yeah. The installer or whatever.
Yeah, you could where you can say which default desktop you want. Instead of saying that, you could have a parallel menu on the first bit of the Debian installer.
Yeah.
Which with the menu being constructed automatically from all the
whatever way suggested, I'm all for it.
Okay.
Yeah. I can't really show this here now.
The point with that is that you could probably include UDebs in your blend and change the nature of the installer at the same time.
Most probably, but we are lacking the technical manpower in this. So.
Yeah.
Right? So if anybody has some idea, I'm all for it. We have there's also a frequent question, do you have a DVD you can me over? I said, well, the set of Debian DVDs is actually our work, but people want this one, right? This is Debian Med or whatever. And so you can do it easily by using Debian Live and put all the meta package on it. Then you have it. Or you can do some other clever tricks. But this would be nice if somebody would do this. And well, what I'm always doing, these web pages, which are now vanished because when it is gone, network is gone, they contain everything translated with PubCon stuff. And maybe it's working again. Showing again. No network. Whatever. I don't know. Maybe it's back now. Yes, it's back. What I'm always advertising is we have all this translated description what belongs to the blend. So if there is a colleague of mine, I made it also for my colleagues. They are working on different operating systems, right? Using sometimes free software, are not aware of this. I said, well, we have all these applications. You have screenshots. Well, you should have screenshots on the right. Here, you have screenshots. Okay, you can upload screenshot if it is missing. You can translate. Here you see it's just the German locale to see it is really translated, and everything is coming from UDD. So the only thing you do to structure your blend is say depends package name, and everything is done with this framework. We have dedicated bugs pages. So if a biologist wants to help Debian to fix a bug, he can go to the biology topic and find the bugs in these. And we have other tools which are ready for any topic. It just need to be used. I will run two other buffs with Debian Multimedia, Debian GIS, and Debian Games, and we try to do it. In Bosnia and Herzegovina, in the DebCon 11, I was sitting in the Debian Games buff, and it was 45 minutes, and I started from scratch and made them a template, a framework, which up to these web pages. There was no change until now to put another other games or make some other tasks which are, I'm lacking the knowledge about games, right? This knowledge needs to be put into the framework, and perhaps we make something out of this or try to revitalize Debian Junior or so.
The problem with games is that they are so diverse that we would probably need to compartmentalize that because, for example, it's not the same kind of people who play Quake than who play, chess. And it's all inside the same team. So probably in Debian Junior or however we decide to call it, it might be quite easier because the age range is different, but we might need to separate between different
I'm sorry if I interrupt you, but that's not really the point. We have hospital information system, biology, medical imaging. This is as far as different things like Quake and Frozen Bubble or so, or whatever. So we just, oh, time's over. We just need to find the right categories for them. But we can discuss it later.
Is there a way to make like tags or something like that to filter similar packages? Like, for example, I'm interested in this kind of game development.
We can do it.
That would be helped.
So time is over. Thank you, everybody.
So, had one more question. Do you want to? Okay, then.
Okay. Thank you.